there are essentials. You know, it's so difficult to manage a child, and she was managing two. One the book and one the child. So congratulations. I think
I'm slightly psychopathic because I wrote three non-fiction books while nursing. I was also very bored because I'm sitting there like 12 and a half hours and anyway not sleeping.
Okay, video recording.
I watched Netflix for a month and I said I can't do this. And I ended up writing three books, one of which this is.
And now she's kind of putting her heart and soul in this book.
Yeah.
And it's all over. As in, you go on to social media, this book is there. You go to the stores, the book is there. You talk to people wanting to write a book, this book is there. So pretty much, I think she's...
Thank you, Ravi. You're very, very kind. By the way, Ravi... She's like Abhi signed up. The book is on the last slide, sorry. Thank you. Ravi is one of the best selling authors in India. If you don't know how to be a bestseller, you really don't have anyone else. But I've not prepared any intros like a completely lazy person. So, do you want to introduce yourself? Everybody knows who they are, right? I don't really need to introduce them. Okay, bad. So, Ravi, first question. So, do you guys want to just open it up and just ask them questions, or do you want me to do a formal like discussion?
I just like to bring in something. Mega, I used to work something very important about, you know, having the full manuscript ready before sending it out. Okay, I did completely the reverse for my first book.
Really?
Yeah. I sent three chapters out, no query letter, nothing, on a random email that I gained off the Westland website. And I got a call back saying that we'd like to see the rest of the manuscript. And I had no rest of the manuscript. But that was not a good place to be in. So I did exactly what Meghna said you'd do. I went back and I wrote it in an embarrassingly short time, which I shall not mention in public.
3 weeks.
So that's what you do when you send it out without having the full manuscript ready. You hustle and you make sure you finish your book and you send it out. Thankfully, they liked it. So.
Yeah, but Kiran was lucky. So,
very lucky.
Normally, normally publishers don't hand out contracts basis the synopsis in 3 chapters. So you are better served if you have a manuscript ready or at least close to completion. Once you have a complete manuscript, you probably have a better chance, a better shot of getting published. But yes, on the flip side, the frustrations also start running high because you're ready with the manuscript and there's no publisher.
Yeah.
So you tend to catch the first publisher who says yes to you and give it to him. So maybe that's not a good idea. Be patient. And,
so, you know, I'll very quickly start with both your publishing journeys because I think that would be very interesting. All the mistakes you made, all the successes you saw. But your successes are in the public domain, obviously. But what about the mistakes or the failures, like if you guys don't mind sharing that? I think that'd be interesting to hear, right?
A couple of them. One, when I started writing, my first book was in God Was a Banker, which was about a story of two people in a bank and how their careers kind of move up and how they kind of, both of them are successful on the right way, on the wrong way, and what eventually happens to them. Heavily inspired by reality. But the mistake which I did was that once I signed with a publisher, I sent out the manuscript to some 4 publishers, one of them reverted back and I got lucky and the book got published. But I didn't focus so much on editing.
Yeah.
So when you are a new, when you are a first time author and you don't do all the things which Meghna told you, the publisher will not invest in you. The publisher will not put a good, strong editor on your manuscript.
Yeah.
Because for him, you are a punt. You may work, you may not work. Please remember, for you, that's the only book, but for the publisher, there are hundreds of other books.
Yeah.
So the best editors go to the best authors, or at least the most commercially successful author. So if you actually now pick up my first book and my last book, you can actually see the entire journey from, you know, in terms of writing style, in terms of language, in terms of content, in terms of editing, etc. So I think never leave anything to the publisher.
Yeah.
Take charge of everything that concerns a book. I keep saying this at various forums that an author is the CEO of his book. So right from writing, publishing, content, the format that you asked about in terms of paperback or hardbound, everything, you know, have a say in what you want, and demand if you think something is not going right. What is the worst which happens? The guy will say no, but at least demand.
That's very good advice, actually, because I think as new authors, you're so sort of grateful for even having got a contract that you just get rolled over, which you shouldn't actually. Kiran, what about you?
You all know the story of my first book, so I'm not going to repeat that, and I don't advise you to do it also. It's just, I got lucky. The mistakes I have done, I think, which I keep getting told all the time, is that I don't stick to one genre. So I have flitted from fiction to non-fiction, from chick lit to romance to literary fiction, to everything possible, to thriller, to horror, thriller and horror written in a very literary fiction kind of a way. So I'm difficult to market. I become difficult to market. So if you're looking at commercial success, I say find your niche and stick to it. If you're an idiot like me, you'll write across the board.
So am I.
Even I write across the board.
No, I don't agree with you on this. I think an author should probably test his boundaries. He should start writing in different fields and try and see if he can write. See, for me, writing in the world of banking is very easy because I worked there for 25 years.
Yeah.
But can I write something else? Can I write beyond that? So that's what you need to test out and see if you can. How many of you would like to read a non-mythological novel from Amish? Quite a few of them, right?
Yeah.
So I think...
So you would read the author, not the genre, right?
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. But that is contrary to what you keep getting told by the publishers.
Yes, my publisher, when I wanted to write a romance novel, turned around and said, look, it won't sell. Okay. And the rationale, which I realized later, was that if you are a thriller and if they invest in marketing you as a thriller writer, your backlist also sells in the same So in the same promotion. Whereas if you write across genres, then you have a problem in terms of positioning and marketing you. But I guess that's okay. Today, if given a chance, I would write across.
But I know an author who writes thrillers but markets himself as a romance author, you know who I'm talking about. Because it sells and his publishers want him to do that. So, kuch bhi kitab likhta hai, but he marketed as a romance novel. And people are, it's amazing the kind of jewel that he's going on.
I have a question. So, you both published in traditional publishing houses, if not sales.
All of us.
So, then what was the marketing that you had to undertake? Because then the publisher do the marketing or then you have to make service?
So people are going to hear the question was, what is the marketing that you have to do and should you do the marketing or should the publisher do the marketing? Look, let's look at the commercials. You are a new author. Assuming that you are very successful, you sell 20,000 copies. 20,000 copies is like super successful in terms of a new author. At $300, the publisher gets $150 because 50% goes into discount for all the stores. 150 into 20,000 is how much? 30 lakhs, right? So the publisher's total turnover on your book is 30 lakhs, out of which there's production cost, there's distribution cost, there's returns, and hence the, so about 15 odd lakhs goes in that. So publishers left with only 15 lakhs, out of which he has to pay you your royalty and your commissions. So what does he have left to really invest in a good marketing campaign for you? So if you take up all the successful authors in India at this point in time, they have actually gone out and marketed their own books themselves. They have not relied on the publisher. A publisher will latch on to a successful marketing campaign if the book does well. But he is not going to start that marketing campaign for you. You will have to do it yourself.
So the reason we use the traditional publishing houses for their distribution
networks. Correct.
Basically,
correct. So self-published authors don't get that distribution access.
Correct.
Which is why on average they sell like 50 copies, unfortunately.
And also credibility. So when you're published by a publishing house, you can enter your book for awards and, you know, there's a lot more credibility attached to being published traditionally than to being self-published. There's that distinction that you will find when you get self-published.
There is a caste system which exists in the publishing hierarchy today.
Yeah.
You have the MNC publishing houses, then the large Indian publishing houses. then the small Indian publishing houses, then the self-publishing houses. So you typically, the higher you go in the hierarchy, you stand to gain in terms of stature as an author.
Therefore, what are the
kind of
things you need to do to market yourself, especially online?
So I'm awful on social media, but Kiran is a star now. She's so good on social. Even before I became an author, I was like, I had little stars in my eyes whenever I thought of Kiran Manwala. I was like, wow, social media goddess. And then she was, no, you were very, very good. And when I met her, she was so kind. And like, even without knowing me, you were like so accessible and so kind. And you were so generous with your time. And she's always been very, very, even Ravi has been very kind in terms of their time and efforts to be the new author that time. So give us some, so, I mean, your book is, your essay in the book is also about, so Kiran wrote a beautiful essay in the book about how to use social media to maximize your brand as an author. But I'm sure you can share some, do you want to read or do you want to say?
I'll just by the way, even I was a new author at that time when I met you. My book was just out, we were both new and still finding our way around.
Yeah.
But the difference was that I had an established blog presence. I had been blogging for a while. And people knew me, so it wasn't as a, I wasn't coming in cold. So there was a whole lot of following that knew my style, my writing. I had established relationships with them. What I always say and what I've said in the book also is, social media is not about going there and shouting about your book and saying, this is my book, read it. That's not gonna happen. You have to build up conversations, relationships. Find the media that works for you. If you're a words person, which you should be if you're a writer, then Twitter works great, Facebook works great. Also learn how to use Instagram. Instagram is very popular. It depends on what your audience is. If your audience is younger, then I don't know, maybe Snapchat or Vine or whatever. I'm not familiar with those. My son has to educate me about all those. But build relationships. That's your first thing. Get into conversation. Make friends on social media. Don't be someone who just comes in and constantly talks about your books. You have to talk about other things. And then skip in your book. Little small doses. We tend to get insufferable when our book is just coming out because there's a lot of pressure.
I get very like insufferable. And I feel sorry for people who follow me. I'm like, bichare, ko thoda mithai bhejni chahiye.
So you know, you tell them, please mute me if I'm getting terrible. But
yeah.
You have to do it for that first 3-4 months that the book is out. But keep, don't be only about your book. Be about a whole range of things, and if they like you, they will be more likely to pick up your book. There's no guarantee.
See, if you want to leverage social media to sell your book or build your brand as an author, you can't be transactional. Okay? Which means that you can't really suddenly have a spurt in social media activity around the time the book is going to come out and then not be seen for the next 6 months. It doesn't work that way. The relationships that she's talking about get built over a period of time and not in over 2 tweets or 10 tweets. So I would say if your book is coming out, start to promote social media interaction for 6 months and start building conversations. At the time when the book comes out, one, while it helps being shameless, okay, and start promoting your book very in a very shameless manner, talk about it, make sure it's out there, make sure people see it. But beyond that, I think what is also important is to go to all your contacts, get them to write and tweet about the books. Okay. Please remember, when even if you look at the authors who are successful and look at their book launches, you would find that around the book, around the day the book gets launched, hundreds of people start tweeting about the book along with the picture. It is not accidental. It's all intentional. They reach out to the friends, irrespective of how big you are. You reach out to your friends, you reach out to your contacts, you reach out to your prior readers and tell them, look, here's the book, please tweet about it, I need you. Okay. And they all do it. Most of them oblige because it's a tweet or a post on Instagram or Facebook. So don't hesitate in leveraging those contacts and get them, because them tweeting about your book gives the book a lot more credibility than you tweeting about your own book. Okay? Your tweet gives them some kind of a handle to use and then further it. But you know, your tweet in itself is meaningless. But more than social media, I think what you should also know, what actually defines a successful book is the presence in the stores. Make sure that you visit as many stores as you want, as you can. Make sure that the store, the people in the store know you, know your book, because then they will be able to recommend the book or keep it right up front in the store. So don't hesitate in pulling it out from back and saying, Abhi, isko yahan rakho. The people in the store are quite happy to do that for you. I do that even now. You know, ask the store guys. I come back and say, why is my book not there in the front? Okay. And then I come and pick it up and keep it there. I think it helps.
I think every author, we've all also put our books on the bestseller list, and bookstores or stuff, which are like, you know, our bestseller.
They don't put it there in the bestseller list.
I don't have that courage.
No, but I think it's the first book once. I was very excited. I said, dekhte hain kaisi lagti hai dar.
I'd just like to add, sorry. There's another thing that you can also look at is blogs. There are a lot of book blogs. A lot of them are commercial. That is, they will charge you to read and review a book, which you may not want to do. But there are a lot of bloggers who do it for the love of books. So, very few of them.
I think these guys are worth it because I'm getting inundated with messages every day for like 3 months.
Pay me 500 rupees, 5000 rupees. So just filter out the 500, 5000, whatever ones and go to the ones who have got genuine following. Go and see which are the best book blogs. Approach them kindly with a nice little letter saying that this is my book and would you like to read it, blah, blah, blah. You never know, you might get lucky. There's no harm in trying. Or as Ravi said, this is not going to happen overnight. Start commenting on their blogs from 6-7 months before your book is out. And build up a relationship with them. So when your book comes out, they know you as somebody who has commented on their blogs and they're more kindly inclined towards you. So that's something you could look at.
And there's no harm in learning from the reviews. Give them the line that you want them to say. You know, if you want a book to be talked about in a particular manner, there is no harm in giving that particular line or two lines or three lines to somebody else and saying, pick your line and then read this. There's no harm. And when they tweet about it, write about it, shamelessly use that as content to promote the book further. But online helps if there is a backup on the stores. Standalone online, I still am very.
You know, I've read this statistic which I put in the book also that only 2% of books that get published actually make it into bookstores. Because of the backlist and, you know, the international books, and nowadays most bookstores, if we walk in, will have like coffee shops and they're selling Hallmark cards and pens and toys because obviously they have their own budgets. So only 20% of most bookstores nowadays even have books. So they'll only sell the best-selling ones. It's a new problem, right?
It is an issue, yeah. But you can get over it by actually, all of you will have at least about 50, 70 friends. Go tell them to walk into bookstores and send you pictures of the book. Okay. So if they can't find it, then go and ask the store guys. Okay. So 10 people walk into Title Wales and ask for a particular book. Title Wales is going to order 20 copies of the book to stock. Right? So it works in that manner. Then you also get pictures of the book saying this is a picture of the book from Title Wales. Use that in. But yeah, you're right.
Unless you have friends like mine who will go and say, I didn't find your book. Did you ask them for it? No.
No, but that's where getting published by a traditional publishing house makes a lot more sense because they have that network and relationship with the stores to help you at least place your book there for 2-3 weeks, if not more.
If you don't have that kind of network who will go to the stores for you or make the noise for you, how do you go about establishing that contact with bookstores?
You will have to do it yourself.
Yeah.
I personally believe, I don't know whether two ladies here would agree with that, but I personally believe the day of the reclusive writer is over. Okay. The writer has to put himself up there in front and be seen.
Yeah. I wanted to sit in my ivory tower when my first book came out, but I realized it's not possible. I would have sat there for till now, but it's not. You have to be very accessible, very out there. And I feel like, especially if, even female authors, we used to be held back, but now I'm seeing like, remember we had this discussion,
you know,
they're really pitching themselves now, and I'm so proud and happy to see that.
You know, Meghna is possibly the best example of that change, of that transformation. I have seen Meghna from the time she wrote her first book.
Yeah.
Okay, when she won that award in Hyderabad.
Oh yeah, right? My God, you have a very good memory.
So